on Rare and Unseen, The Beatles.
I was always in trouble, but if I went into the tough districts and came across real teddy boys, I was in danger, you know? But I liked the, you know, being a rocker. At school it was easier because, you know, I could control them with my head, you know? So they thought I was tougher than I was. So. Because it was Elvis that really got me out of Liverpool, you know? And he said, look, if you really want to get in these bigger places, you're going to have to change, stop eating on stage, stop swearing, stop smoking. Oh, it was a choice of making it or still eating chicken on stage, you know. And then we gradually developed a style of our own. So the only the real difference was that we decided to write our own stuff. We just tried everything. And because we got famous, we were sort of, we said, you know, they're leading fashion. We were buying the things from the shop. And so we never became the Grateful Dead or the Grateful Aeroplane, as Mick Jagger calls them, you know? And so we were always ourselves. You can pick most of the Beatle records. A few of them are obviously of an era, but most of them sound pretty au courant, like Hey Jude, or as songs, you know, Eleanor Rigby. It doesn't matter what period, what era, that'll go down in 200 years, it's the same, you know. Maybe they'll play it a little different or with a different machine. But when it gets down to the nitty-gritty, it's the song. I'm not saying anything, you know, I'm just living my life,
just,
you know.
Being yourself.
I'm an artist, you know. If I'm a political artist, I'm a political artist. And if I'm a religious artist, I'm a religious artist. But I'm an artist first, and all the rest is just me trying to live my life.
On Rare and Unseen, The Beatles.